what we discussed in the last class, like how to create a partition table, how to create a partition table. Once the table has been created, how to load the data into partition table, right? There are multiple ways to load the data into Hive. So we have seen it, right? So how we can load, you can load from the local file system, or you can load from the HDFS itself, or you can use the insert command, or you can use create as table. Create as table. Create as table means from existing table, you can load the data into a new table, right? Or you can also use the command insert override by selecting from other table as well, right? Is that everyone is clear about that? Is everyone clear about that?
Yes, sir.
Right? So let me repeat one more time. How we can load the data into Hive table? One is from the local file system, we can use the load command. For another one is from HDFS itself. Other one is insert into row level insertion, or inserting from other table, or create as, there is something called create as table. Create as, select from the other table, that you can do. Other option is insert, again you are selecting the using, you can use the insert command by selecting some few rows or based on the condition you are selecting from other table, right? The same way, when it comes to the partition table, we can also load the data into partition table multiple ways. Like when you have a data which is a specific partition, let's assume that I have data which is belong to Karnataka, I have data which belong to Andhra Pradesh, I have data which is belong to Tamil Nadu, I have some data is belong to some other states, state wise I have a data, right? In that case, what I will do, I will load the data into Hive table state wise, correct? Let's see what we were discussing, right? Let me go to that file. This is the data description. I have sent you sometime before about the data description. Hive programs. This is what we have done, correct? This is the one only, right? Yep. Let me see. Correct. This one only. Right? That one only we have done. Let me close other. I don't, what is this? Assignments, yes, this is what we are discussing about, okay? So let me close this, let me close this. Let me close this. Yeah, this is something different. This is also, we have already discussed about data description when I have loaded into a specific file. Okay. Yeah, this is what we have done last class. We have a data country-wise, India, US, UK. I have a data country-wise, then I loaded into a partition table. I have loaded into a partition table. Right, which is stock underscore partition table, right? So later what we decided, other way, this is one way of loading the data and we can fetch the data in this. So other way what we have decided, create some stage table, load the stage table with all the data, create all the data into this partition table. Let me open this. Create some temporary table where we have all the data is loaded into that. All the data is loaded into that, and selecting specific portion of the data. It means selecting specific type of data. Let's look at here. So I will issue a query such a way that I will load the whole data into that partition in a staging table, and I will create one partition table. I'll create first a temporary table which is called staging table. I loaded the data into staging table. After loading the data into staging table, I will create one partition table. I'll create one partition table. What are the partition I want, right? So country or what are the partition you want. After that, what we will do, we will write a partition. We will write a query which will fetch the data from the temporary table and which insert into our specific partition table. How it is? Look at here. So I have only single partition. I don't need this. Let me remove this. Okay. This is my partition table, right? So stock underscore partition. This is my table name. Insert override table and table name partition country equal to US, country equal to US from stay stock table, from stay stock table. You can say SS and you can say SS here, country where this country equal to this and where country equal to this, and you don't have a state, so you can remove it. This is my query to fetch the data from other table, and insert into your partition table. In this case, you have to write multiple insert queries for each state. Each country. Let's assume that I have 50 countries. I need to write same kind of queries 50 times. Yes or no? It's first US, next EN, IN, next IN. Next, I have to write one more query such a way that UK. I have to write one more query here, UK. Right? And so on, I have to write. Right? This is also another way to fetch the data. This is also another way to fetch the data from an existing table. Clear, guys? This is another way to fetch the data from an existing table into your partition table. So let me repeat what I have done once again. So I have created one stage table, or you can call it as a temporary table, or you can call it as a raw table. I have loaded whole data which has all the countries, not only India, all the data. The data has mix of all the countries. Now from that staging table or from the temporary table, I need to create a partition table. So what is the purpose of the partition? Which will improve the performance. So if you do a partitioning, the query performance will give the very quick. I mean, like you don't need to scan the whole data. So what are the where class you are passing, respect to where class, respect to folder only it will be scanned, right? You don't need to scan the whole data to fetch the records. So to achieve that, what I have done, anyway, my data is already there in the one temporary table. Now I'm creating a partition table. I'm creating one partition table by using create table, table name and partition table name and our columns and partition by respect to which column you want to partition by, and row format delimited terminated by comma, stored as a text file. You can take it as a text file, ORC file, whatever the format. We'll discuss about the formats later. Then now we need to fetch the records from the stage table to partition table, correct? From the stage table to partition table. So for that, what I'm doing, insert override this table. This is this. I have specified the what partition has to fetch from where and put it where. Now in this case, I'm avoiding the human mistakes. What is a human mistake? If you guys remember last class, what I have done, I have loaded India data into UK. Last class, if you guys remember, what I have done last, the mistake, there are chances like this I did yesterday, if you guys remember, I mean the last class. But I'm loading India data, but by mistake I specified here country as UK. By specified country as UK. So it's a human mistake, right? What I have done, I'm fetching the data from, I'm loading the data from local file system and loading into UK partition, but the data is belong to India partition. That's a human mistake. I can avoid that human mistake by writing query like this, but here also there are chances where you can commit the same kind of mistake. How? So you are fetching, let's assume that you are fetching the data which is Japan, or the data which is belong to something, California or something, but you are loading into UK partition. Still you have same kind of mistake you may commit here. You may commit here. By specifying right, you may commit that. Yes or no, guys? There are chances where you can commit a mistake like this. But okay, fine, you are not committing any mistakes, but for each and every country you have to write one statement. For each and every country you have to write one statement, which is again bad coding. Let's say today you are fetching for 50 countries, tomorrow all of a sudden there are more countries are coming, so again you have to write so many queries for that. To avoid that, we have something called dynamic partition. Look at guys here. So we can override existing partition with the help of override into table partition class. There is alternative for bulk loading of partition into hive table, as data is already present in HDFS and should be made accessed by Hive. We will just mention the location of the Hive. How we can do that? That's what I'm trying to say here. The data is already available in HDFS, which is belong to a specific country. Let's say I have a data of India in a specific location. So what I will do, I'll just go here, my partition table, alter table name and partition, add partition. This is my country and this is state as a California and location is this. It means I can point out an existing data. Right? So in this case what happened, if our files on the local FS, then we can move to directory HDFS and we can add the partition for each file. So there are multiple ways to load the data into your partition table. But what is the problem you see here? You have to write multiple insert queries. You have to write so many insert queries. And there are chances where you can commit mistakes. There are chances where you can commit human mistakes, like you're specifying country as this, but you're loading the different data. So far, so good, guys. Are you able to follow? Guys, clear? What kind of mistakes you may commit?
Yes, sir.
So to avoid that mistakes, instead of loading each partition with a single SQL statement shown above, which will result writing a lot of SQL statement for huge number of partitions. If you have so many partitions, you have to write so many queries. I support something called dynamic partition, which we can write only one query where it will fetch the whole data into put into a respective partition location. We can add any number of partition with a single SQL query. Hive will automatically split our data into separate partition files based on the value you have given to your partition table. Let's do it, how it will be. So very simple, guys. It gives an advantage of easy coding and no need to a manual identification of the partition. Before in our code, we need to identify what is the partition code. What is my partition? I have to identify it. But when it comes to the dynamic, you no need to specify, you no need to identify. So this dynamic partition suits well for our example requirement on the here user record. Say we are taking first name, last name and all those things, right? So here also what we will do, we'll keep the data into a staging table, and we will fetch from the staging table. Here also we'll keep the data into staging table. From staging table we will fetch by writing a single query. How it is possible? Let's look at guys here. For dynamic partition loading, we will not provide a value for the partition key. What does it mean? We will not hard code. This is the country, this is the country. Like that, we will not hard code. What we will write, insert into table, table name, partition, what are the partition columns? And select from temporary table. It's automatically fetch the records from your staging table. It'll identify, okay, I have to do a partition based on the country. If I find a different country name in the that staging table or a temporary table, let's create a folder for it, load the data in it. So to do this one, we need to enable some configurations. That's called, we need to enable dynamic partition. Go ahead, Sunil.
Yeah, the temporary table, just dump, that is just insert without partition or anything, just raw data was available in temporary, that is nothing but a staging table.
Correct.
From there we will dynamically partition and load it to production tables. That's what you are saying, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Right. If what happened, if I have something like, if I have something like whole data is available in one table, it's not like a partition data. All the data is there in a single location, one table. So now I want to fetch the piece by piece, like country wise or date wise or state wise. So I can go and fetch from that by using the select query. Understand?
Okay.
Look at here. We can do mixed dynamic and static as well. Both also will possible. Dynamic and static also is possible. We will see how it is. So in the partition, suppose you want to fetch only a respective state only, but country has to be fixed. Country is always US, and the state and different states only I need to pick. In that case, you can hard code the country and you can leave state as it is. While fetching the data, yes, it will fetch all the state related data which is there in the country, US. Okay, but static partition key must be come before the dynamic partition. Okay, we will talk about this. There are some different kind of modes available in the dynamic partition. We will see that. Look at guys here. But by default, dynamic partition is desirable in a Hive. Why Hive is, okay, dynamic partition is really good. Then why dynamic partition has been disabled by default in Hive? Very simple reason, guys. So when you create a partition, what you are trying to do, you are creating a folder and you're putting your data in it, right? That information has to track by whom? Your name node, correct? Let's assume that you have created dynamic partition on employee IDs. By mistake you have created by employee ID. And if you see how many employees will be there in a company, 10,000 members, let's assume that. Very small company, 10,000 members are there. 10,000 folders will be created. 10,000 files will be created under 10,000 folders. Now, 10,000 partition has to be kept track by whom? Your name node. Which is a burden to name node. We're simply unnecessarily increasing a burden to a name node. By mistake you have specified employee ID is a partition and it has created number of partitions which will again impact on your cluster management, like your name node will be impacted. The name node memory will be eaten up, right? So to prevent the accidental partition creation, the dynamic partition is by default desirable. To use a dynamic partition, we need to set below properties, either Hive shell or hive.xml. What is a Hive shell? So we can directly do from the here only, no? So I have shown you set command using set and space, the power and your property equal to true false, we have did it, right? Let's add to the sessions. Let me restart the sessions. Okay. Sorry, that's the one I need to make it active, right? Let me restart my sessions. Okay, so now let's open my data. This is for Hive. Okay, so start bash rc. So now hive.exe, I need to do it. And this is for MySQL hyphen u root hyphen p root. And this is let it be for HDFS to see the HDFS. Let's look at all the services running. Very good. All services are running. And let's move here. Hive is also running. And you can see your commands. You can see the previous commands what we have executed. I want to see this print header true. And set CLI current DB also I want to make it true. Because I want to see which database I'm using. My current DB also should be true. So use test 530. I'm going to use the test 530 is our database, if you guys remember. Okay, now let's go back. Look at guys here. What is the using shell or other one is using HiveSite.xml? HiveSite.xml is nothing but if you use the if you change your configuration HiveSite.xml, it will be impacted to everyone in the whole environment. If you set in this HiveSite.xml, if you set in the your Hive shell, which is specific to that your session only, okay, that the specific to that session only. As soon as you come out from that session, the properties will be disabled. I mean the properties again go back to the normal, right? So let's go back here. Okay, so let me show you what is the configurations available in your HiveSite.xml or Hive default template. So vi, or you can use the cat command, or let's say vi command, vi slash user local Hive. I think I have Hive 2. In that I have something called conf. In that I have something default template. Let's look at here. Okay, let's look at search for dynamic. If you guys look at here, guys, look at guys here. Okay, look at here. This one first. Hive.exe.dynamic.partition. It is true whether or not to allow the dynamic partition in the DML or DDL command. And hive.exe.dynamic.partition.mode is strict mode. There are two type of modes, guys. One is a strict, another one is non-strict. In the strict mode, the user must specify at least one static partition. So I'll show you, I'll explain you what is that. It means your partition should have at least one dynamic, at least one static. At least one static if it is a strict mode. And other one in case, other one is non-strict mode. In a non-strict mode, all partitions are dynamic. All partitions are allowed dynamic. Not only that, there is some other configuration we need to understand here. Hive.exe max dynamic partitions are 1000. By default, the maximum it will allow 1000 only. You cannot go ahead and create 10,000, 20,000 like that, right? But per node is okay. So these are the values, guys. By default values, and I don't think I have modified my default XML file. It is also actually 1000. Well, then why it is showing 100? Not sure. Maybe I changed. Okay. Fine. Let's say there is some default value. But I think this is the default value as 1000. I don't know whether it is. I changed here sometime before, maybe for explaining to other students. So hive.exe.max dynamic partitions per node is 100. I think it's a 100 only maybe. So what does it mean? For each partition under that, you can have a 100 or 100 or 1000. So these are the configurations we need to. These are the configurations we need to enable while you are going for partition, while you are going for dynamic partition. Look at guys here. These are the configurations we need to modify in our hive.xml, or you can set them in a by using set hive like this in from the shell as well. Either you can do here or do. If you do here, it is temporarily for that shell, and if you do it here, it is for global. It will be impacted to everyone in the whoever using that environment. Okay, look at guys here. This is a little interesting thing we need to understand here. Here, except dynamic partition mode property, remaining three are self-explanatory, because what is a dynamic partition is enabled or disabled, the mode, and how many partitions it allowed maximum, and maximum partition per node it allow how many. So by default, dynamic partition mode is set to strict mode, strict in the hive, to specify at least one static partition should be there. Why it is by default strict? Very simple guys. If it is strict mode, I should specify the hard-coded value. If it is a strict mode, if you see here, I need to specify at least one is a hard-coded value. If I am specifying at least one hardcode value, I am know that I am avoiding to create unnecessary partition. Let's say it's a non-strict mode. If you are creating partition such a way that country and state wise, let's say you are going to create partition by country and state both using country and both, in each country can have different number of states, each country can have again different number of states. It means you are creating India, under India you are creating, let's assume that another so many states, and you are creating US, under that you are creating so many states. This means you are creating unnecessarily, you are creating so many partitions. To avoid that, so by default Hive come up with something called strict mode, where you can specify country equal to, you have to hard code by default. So if you hard code something, you'll be knowing that what you are going to do a partition. So let's say if I do IN here, so I have been restricted, I can create only subdirectories here, very less. I can create only subdirectories are very less. At least you are avoiding to do something. That's why your Hive by default come up with the strict mode. Okay, if you don't want to that, you can go ahead and change it. It's always open for changes, so you can change it. So which prevent the generation of the huge number of the partition by badly designed query. So if by mistake someone is did this, so there might be a chances where they can end up with so many partitions, and we may face a name node burden, or name node RAM has been eaten up for this unnecessary created partitions. Note that the dynamic partition strict mode is different from Hive strict mode. So this is another important point we need to remember guys. There is something called hive.maproot.mode is strict. There is another strict mode in your Hive site.xml only. That is, if you enable that maproot mode is strict, if enable maproot mode is strict, you cannot do a Cartesian product, you cannot do order by without limit, you cannot access without where clause, you cannot use without where clause, and you have where clause. Not only that, comparing between the data types like begin to string and begin to doubles is not allowed. It's not allowed. Let's look at here. But in the real time, in the right time, it's a discussion about this MapReady strict mode also, because we need to discuss about this. So because people will be asking you, what is the dynamic.partition.mode strict mode, and what is the hive.mapReady strict mode? What is the difference between these two? So the first one, anyway, I just explained you guys know it. If it is a strict mode, I have to hard code at least one partition, and the rest of the things will pick automatically. So we are preventing some unnecessarily creating partitions. But when it comes to hive.mapReady.mode equal to strict, what it is, it's real, it says that your MapReady operations cannot be done if it is a strict mode. So there are some here you can look at here. So these cannot be performed. These cannot be performed. They have some strict operations. What are they? So if MapReady is strict mode, some risky queries cannot be allowed to run. What are they? Are Cartesian product. What is a Cartesian product, guys? One too many. Let's say I have two data sets. Let us assume that I have in one data set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is a, I mean, let's assume that this is my IDs, and I have another one 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When it's Cartesian products, means like this, and again 2 also will do the same, and 3 also will do the same. It means it's unnecessarily making burden on this, right? If it is a MapReady strict mode, this kind of Cartesian products are not allowed, right? And also no partition being picked up for a query. No partition has been, you cannot pick the specific partition without where class. You should have a where class. You should have a where class. Without where class cannot be picked. Comparing begint and strings, comparing string begint and doubles, and order by without limit. Order by without limit. You are doing order by, but you should specify the limit. So if your MapReady hive dot, your MapReady dot mode is strict, you cannot allow these following operations. So according to find 5 and 2 and 5, 2 is like no partition being, and our last one order by is, we cannot use select statement without at least a partition key. It means that we have to use the where class. You have to use the where class, right? If you are in a strict mode, you are not using where class, you are not picking the specific partition, like where, it will not be allowed. And you are using order by, you have to use the limit. You are using order by, you have to use the limit. If you are using order by, you have to use the limit operation, right? So this is the thing. But anyway, you not to worry about it. By default, it is non-strict mode. If you want to look at that, you can look at that MapReady.mode. So let's go back your hive thing. You can do this. Hive.mapReady.mode is a non-strict. So deprecated, use hive strict.checks settings instead. Okay, it has been deprecated. It's because it's the latest version. So they have provided another strict.checks. There is something called strict.checks. Strict.checks large query. So by default it's a false. By default it's false. You can see here enabling strict large query checks the disallow the following: order by without limit, no partition being picked up for the query against partition table. If you have a partition table, you cannot, without a where class you cannot do. But if we are creating a partition for to do a where class, if you are not using a where class, means there is no meaning of it, right? We are creating a partition for where class only. Based on the where class only, we are going to create a partition, right? Where country equal to this, country equal to this, country equal to this. So because based on the where class only, we are creating a partition. If you are not using the where class, there is no point to create partitions. So that's why you cannot query select query without having a where class in the partition. Note that these checks currently do not consider data size, only the query pattern. So it is really no matter whether you have a very big data or less data, anyway that's no matter here. So there is another checks here. You can also see a type safe, as I said, comparing begin to strings, begin to double comparing, and Cartesian product. So they have, I mean, it was before, it was like only one condition, then they have made it multiple conditions and multiple properties. So now the latest version and also what they have done, type safe is a different property and Cartesian product is a different property and the query pattern is a different property. So they have divided the configurations for each and everything. So not only one strict mode, so you can have a multiple. I can have a comparing the type safe, but I don't want the this large query. But I want the large query, I don't want the safety. I want the large query, I don't want the Cartesian product. But I don't want other two, I want the Cartesian product. So you have a flexibility that which one needs to be enabled, which one needs to be disabled. Clear guys? Is this clear? Everyone? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Madhu, Srini, Sunil, Anila.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So let's look at another example here. Let me finish. Today we'll try to finish this dynamic partition. So please do hands-on as well. So you have a data sets and you can also make use of that. Example use cases as similar as that. So what are the use case we are seeing that? So create a dynamic partition table for user records, provide a first page on the post, like what we have seen there. You have a first name, last name, website, address, phone number, and country, state, all are there. All are there. So now I am going to create a partition on top of it. As this input file contains a partition key also field in each record, we need to create a temporary user table. As I said, temporary table we need to create, and with all the columns input file, from that need to extract the columns needed into partition key. So I want the country and state, so I am going to create one more table as I explained before, and country and state as a partition key. Let's examine the performance of the temporary table and the partition table. So you can also look at the performance. So you try to fetch from the temporary table and how much time it is taking, and try to fetch from the partition table how much time it is taking. You can easily differentiate which one is giving a better performance, right? We can create a temporary table and partition table also by using a dynamic partition with the help of the Hive query language. After going through all above, this one is mandatory, so we need to enable these configurations. It has to be next line, the set has to be next line. And look at guys here, I have created a temporary table with all the fields. Here all fields are the temporary table. First name, last name, address, country, city, state, postal, phone, web and email, and all I have created. And I have loaded the data into that by using load command. I have loaded the data into that table. Now I'm going to create, okay, here just we are using a select query. So to fetch the records, whether to check whether the data is loaded or not. And next one I'm creating with the partition. Next one I'm creating with the partition table by using country and state. And my query is looks like this. Insert into table partition. I have not hard coded anything in a partition key. In a partition key. And you can select it. You can see the performance. You can see the performance. Here it is showing the performance differentiation, guys. Nothing else. Okay. So here it is showing the performance difference. So let me keep it, you know, the document which we are following, because the same document I'll be sharing with you once our queries, everything is done. This I'll be sharing these things to for you guys. So anyway, these things I'll be sharing with you guys. Okay, so that's why I'm keeping in a single document. Order by, you can state, city, and limit You can use 10 or whatever the thing you want. Okay, and limit is 5 here. So create partition table and insert into this. So let me put this here. So I'll keep it, I'll put it in a single document. I'll format it properly and I'll put it here. Okay, now so I hope everyone is understand, right? Everyone understand what is the difference between the dynamic and static. And the dynamic also, there are two modes. One is a strict mode and non-strict mode. How to do that? So we got some idea, right? So now I'm going to explain something. As of now, we are executing query by query in a shell. Yes or no, guys? Query by query we are executing here. Like select, like that query. So what about a batch query? Number of queries I need to execute. So what we will do, we will keep all our queries in a single file. And we will save that as a HQL or SQL, whatever the extension you want to, you can save that, and you can use the command hive space hyphen F option. You can load, you can use that command and you can execute that as like this, hive hyphen F and your table, hive hyphen F and your table, hive hyphen F and the table you can execute. So this is this partition dot table HQL has all the code and you are executing using hyphen F command. Okay, you can also do one more thing, guys, here. Let me show you that. Show tables, products, right? Something went wrong. Spelling of limit. Okay. What happened? No data is available, I think. Why data is not there in it? Or else we can select other table, not a problem. I just want to show you something like how much other option. One is a hyphen F option, other one is a hyphen S option. Hyphen S option. Category and SRS. Hi, I'm outside right now. I'm not in hive prompt. Hyphen E select start from where. Okay, limit, let's give 5. No, source dot it will fetch the some records. There is another option called hyphen hyphen E option. Hyphen E option. One is hyphen F option, other one is hyphen E option. So I want to show you hyphen E option, how to make use of it. So that's why I'm fetching some records. You can also give like this. Semantic query, table not found. Okay, so I need to specify here my database name as well. Test 530 dot, otherwise it will look into the default database, right? So it will look into default database. So we need to specify the database name dot and table name. Let's take, yeah, see you guys here. By using hyphen E option, without entering into high prompt, you are able to query. So here, one is hyphen E option, other one is hyphen F, and you can give the file name. So my queries dot SQL, or you can give HQL, whatever it is. Okay, so I thought to bring these two and I have explained this. So here the result of these things you can look at here, you can understand this. So now not only that, where you can see all the partitions, where you can describe the partitions, where you can alter the partitions. Look at guys here, show partitions will list out all the partitions, show partition at the table name, and specifying by, so you want to see the partitions and specify by the specific partition, that also will show, like directory and a subdirectory. Very simple guys, ls command. The show partition is nothing but a kind of ls command. When you say show partitions, it will list out all the parent directory as well as the subdirectories. Parent directory as well as the subdirectories. And you want to see only subdirectories. So you specify for whom you want to see. And describe. So when you describe for partition table, the specific partition, it will describe what is the columns and what is the partition column and all. So we already seen this. Describe formatted this and partition by USA and Canada. California. So it will list out the only specific to that. List out to only specific to that portion. Right? Alter. Yes, we can do, we can alter the existing partitions. We can change the partitions. So before initially I was preferring a old data, which was the USA and California. So I can give a new path. Altering. You can drop the partition. If you don't want one partition, you can drop the partition. Why we are able to do all these things? Very simple. These are all folders in HDFS. So you can do it because with respect to HDFS, it's just a folders. You can go ahead and remove, or you can go ahead and add, whatever the operations you can do, you can do that. That's why all these are allowed to do from the Hive. Okay. So this is about the partitioning guys. So I request you guys to go through this document once again, detailly, and the data sets already provided. Please have a look. And if you guys have any doubt or any if you're facing any problem while doing this partitioning, please call me or you can message me. Okay, so tomorrow and after tomorrow no classes guys, as Friday, Saturday, Sunday no classes, tomorrow and after tomorrow we'll be having next class and Monday morning. Okay, thank you guys, thanks for your time, have a great day.